I know, it's like a dance party.
All right, 12 monologues, 26 productions, hundreds of actors, all against the backdrop of 55,000 homeless people in LA County alone.
A new project called Homeward LA aims to shed light on the homeless epidemic by showcasing the personal stories of people who have struggled living on the streets. Their biographies will be told in multiple productions starting this Friday. And Kate Mansi, who you will recognize from Days of Our Lives, will be performing one of those monologues. She's here to tell us all about Homeward LA. It's nice to see you.
Yes, it's nice to see you guys. Thanks
for having me. Did you come up with this idea? Because it says to contact you for more information.
No, but you can contact me. That's fine. No, Jason Lesner was the creator, and he really had this idea to have a citywide event to raise awareness for homelessness and to raise funds. So he joined with the Midnight Mission. And then he has writers that have spent so much time with these 12 individuals who have experienced homelessness and or addiction. And these writers have donated their time and spent time with these people and put their stories into monologue form to be performed by actors like myself and so many other people that are also donating their time. So it's a really special, amazing show. You know, some of these monologues will make you laugh and some of them will make you cry, but it's definitely an important show, especially for Los Angeles right now.
I'm sure I saw the video there of the first reading,
the promo.
But to read it for the first time, especially because it's such a personal story, mm-hmm. what was your reaction to reading it and to tell the story about one particular person?
Yeah, I'm so glad you asked me that. I think as actors, sometimes we have this pressure to be the, you know, the real person. And what is so incredible about this project is you approach the material and you look at it and inevitably, you know, only a few sentences in, you start relating and you realize that what these are not stories about just about someone that, you know, this is the event of how I was, you know, on Skid Row and how I came to homelessness. It's their stories about their lives, and it really it just makes you realize the humanity, and it just gives these stories such a voice that you can relate to it. And I think as audience members, it's in a format that's so much more digestible and you're able to absorb it when you're sitting back. And sometimes we're faced with it so much that we don't know quite how to wrap our minds around it because it's such a big crisis. Mm-hmm. But sitting back and hearing these shows, the audience gets a real opportunity to be able to have the same experience I did when I read the monologue, which was like, to really look at it and realize that they're not that different from
they're
us.
People.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. It changes your perspective.
Totally.
Now, did you have an opportunity to actually meet the person who you'll be talking about?
Yes, I did, yeah. And I've met all of them, and I have to say, that was one of the reasons why I decided to produce two of the shows with my producing partner, Kevin. And we, you know, you talk to these individuals. I sat there at the table read, and they are just so grateful to have their stories told, and they feel so much pride. And I think that is, if nothing else comes from that, that's a really amazing, that is why so many people have donated their time and their space and their, you know, all their resources to wrapping their hearts around this project.
It's almost like people who are forgotten because we pass by them all the time. They just look like a mass and a group of people, and we forget that they're all individual people who
sons
worry about.
Sons and daughters and mothers, and yeah, absolutely. And I think that it is a natural impulse to keep driving or look the other way, or, you know, that one day I'll go and I'll, you know, go to LA and I'll go to Skid Row and I'll volunteer. But we need to do this now, you know, so it's a really important, like I said, citywide event that I'm hoping LA will get behind.
And it's not just one night, it's 10 nights.
Yeah.
So what do you want the audience members to walk away, and how do you want them to be changed from this viewing?
I think that everyone's going to have their own unique experience, but I'm from Los Angeles. I grew up here. I've seen the homelessness crisis, like you said. We're sometimes fatigued by it and we don't know what to do with it. So I hope that it allows them to connect with these personal stories, realize that they could easily be on the other side of it, and also to feel empowered to find a way to get involved and to hear these personal stories as more than just, you know, a problem that they have to do something, but to have a real personal connection with it.
All right, well, we hope the audiences and the people out there connect with it. Let's show them the information here.
Yes.
Homeward LA performances, they begin this Friday. They go on for 10 days, so there's lots of different performances that you can go to. Tickets are $20. For more information, including the show times, the locations, just go to the website, homewardla.org. 100% of the proceeds go toward the Midnight Mission, or just go to your social media,
exactly.
Right?
Yeah, just
and
find
she'll
me.
Tell you exactly where you can go.
Yes, at Kay Mansi.
And you're performing awesome. Saturday night.
I am performing this Saturday at the First Congregational Church and on the 21st at Skylight Theater. So,
great.
Yes.
That's what
I mean. Yeah.
Good stuff.
Thank you for being here, Kate Mansi.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.